So how do you draw and trade with support and resistance? In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to draw support and resistance and then trade off these levels for high probability trades. Now, the first key to good support and resistance trading is to be patient. You want to wait for price to approach the level and then confirm whether either price wants to reverse off the level or if price wants to go straight through the level. Second, make sure your indicators confirm what price is doing. For example, you want to make sure momentum has shifted back in the direction that you're supposed to be trading. And then lastly, always, always trade in the direction of the higher time frames. Simply mean, trade with the overall trend of the markets, support and resistance trading. So now let me show you guys how I plot support and resistance levels. As you can see, we're on the New Zealand USD on the weekly time frame, right? And the reason why I chose the weekly time frame is because when you go to the bigger time frame, such as the weekly or the monthly, it allows you to see the entire life cycle of the pair. So this is where the actual Forex trading began for New Zealand USD. This is 1999. All the way to the current year of 2020, right? And if it's true what they say about support and resistance, if price always returns back to these levels, then if I plot support and resistance from 99 till around 2011, then the levels should hold true for 2012 all the way to 2020, right? Because price returns back to these levels. So let's go ahead and plot our support and resistance lines. And here's how I do it. As you can see, I'm on the weekly time frame, New Zealand USD, and I'm using traditional Japanese candlesticks, right? But in order to plot really good support and resistance, let's pan out and let's switch our Japanese candlesticks over to the line graph. Boom. This is the line graph. Now, keep this in mind. When you're plotting support and resistance levels, the way that you know you have a strong support and resistance level, the level should have acted as one-time support and also one-time resistance. Here's what I mean. So let's go ahead and begin plotting on the levels, plotting our levels in. Boom. So this is support, 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 right? Let's plot in the next level. As you can see right here, this is resistance, resistance, support. This line probably can go up just a little bit. All right, let's go to the next level. As you can see right here, you know what? Let's bring this line up a little bit more. Yeah, that's a better line. Support, resistance, minor support right here. Support, support, resistance. Here you go. Support, resistance. Maybe we bring that one up a little higher as well. Resistance, support. Resistance, support, support, support. Support, support, resistance, support. Resistance, resistance, support, support. Again, you may have to make little minor adjustments to the levels, but for the most part, they should act as both support as well as resistance at some period on this chart. Resistance, resistance. I'm pretty sure at another time, at another period on this chart, it's gonna also act as support. Resistance, support, resistance, support. So like I said, we may need to make some minor adjustments to these levels, but for the most part, they should hold. They should hold. So let's look and see what we have. Resistance, resistance, support, support. Sometimes the price does overrun the levels. For the most part, these levels are pretty good. These levels are pretty good. Yep, these levels are pretty good. Alrighty, so let's go ahead and bring the Japanese candlesticks back onto the chart and let's see what we got. Boom. So as you know, we plotted from 2009 all the way until 2011. Right here in this, for this year. Now let's go and see how price reacted from 2012 to 2020 at the same levels. So let me put a line in, all right? Let me take it over one more year. All right, that's the beginning of 2012 right there. So let's see how price reacted. So resistance, support, resistance, resistance. Look at this, support, right at the levels. So when people say support and resistance doesn't mean anything, guys, as you can see, price still reacts to these levels. Resistance, support. Now you may have to make some minor adjustments to your levels, but as we know, support and resistance isn't a straight line. It's an area. But you can see how nicely price reacts to these levels. And since I plotted these levels on the weekly time frame, I would want to take trades based on these levels on the daily time frame. And look at this. Boom. Boom. Look how price reacts to these levels. Boom. Resistance. Sometimes price does overrun the level. So when I say make adjustments, you can bring this level up a little bit right there. But for the most part, price reacts to these levels because support and resistance isn't a straight line. It's an area, guys. So you want to make sure you understand that part. Alrighty. So next, I'm going to show you guys how to trade off these levels. Alright. So what I've done now, I have plotted my support and resistance levels off the daily time frame so we can trade the 4-hour time frame. So again, you plot your support and resistance levels from one time frame higher than your trading time frame. Alright. So let's look at how I take trades. Okay. As you can see, I still have my Japanese candlesticks on the chart. But as you guys know, I use Heiken Ashi candles in my trading because I like to see the trend of the market. So let me go ahead and change these Japanese candlesticks over to my Heiken Ashi candlesticks. So let me go ahead and drop these on, and let me go ahead and just change some of the inputs. I like the bullish candles to be navy blue, my bearish candles to go ahead and be red. I take them off the Japanese because Heiken Ashi is an indicator. So it overlays, it's an indicator that overlays on top of your candles that you have on the chart, right? So I go from, so I have the Japanese candlesticks on the chart, but I overlaid the Heiken Ashi candlesticks on top of the Japanese candlesticks. And now I want to get rid of the Japanese candlesticks and just switch them to the bars. Boom, because I like it to look like that. All right, so let me pan out just a little bit so I can show you guys how I take these trades off these support and resistance levels. So what's rule number one? Rule number one is be patient, right? Be patient and wait for price to give you a confirmation that it wants to go in the direction that you think it wants to go, right? So my first question is, Let's look at this area right here. Let's look from here down to here. Okay. Matter of fact, let me highlight this area. Let me insert a rectangle. Highlight the entire area that we're going to be looking at for trades. This is the area right here. Scale up. So rule number one, be patient. Make sure price is showing you that it wants to reverse, right? Or it wants to reverse off the level, right? Rule number two, make sure your oscillators or your whatever indicators that you're using confirms price for you. Okay. In this example, I am using the moving average as well as my stochastic oscillator. Okay. And three, you want to make sure you're trading in the overall direction of the bigger market, the larger market, right? So I put that line there because everything that I'm saying, it means something. And I'm going to show you guys. All right, so I highlighted the line. So this price is coming up to this level, support and resistance level, right? So my first question is, do we take this trade? Do we trade right off this level? So you want to make sure it comes up. Rule number one, be patient, let it come up, and make sure that price is reversing off the level. Right? Price comes up, it shows this indecision candle, and then it starts to reverse off the level. So do you take this trade? My answer is no, you don't take the trade. Because if you do take this trade, then you violate rule number two and rule number three. Well, you don't violate rule number two, but you violate rule number three. Rule number two says that you want to make sure your oscillators are showing you the same thing that price is showing. So price is showing me that it wants to go down. My oscillators are confirming that price would like to go down as well. The only issue I have with this trade is at this point in the market, it doesn't confirm that we're in a downtrend. It says that we're still in an uptrend. So the uptrend hasn't, the trend hasn't reversed yet, right? So yeah, you could take the trade and you would have been correct, but that's not a part of your trading plan, so to speak, when you talk about rule number three, right? So me, of course, I probably would have taken the trade, but the issue is it violates rule number three, right? Now there is a way to take these trades. What it's called a reversal or continuation trade. There's a way to get trades in this, but if you're a new trader, you don't take this trade, because at this point in the market, and I know hindsight trading is 2020, right? But at this point in the market, this is not showing me that market is in a downtrend. So I don't take this trade. All right. Remember rule number one, be patient, right? And like I said, price goes from level to level when you plot in major support and resistance levels from the higher time frame. The reason I do it is price usually goes from level to level, right? Now, clearly this was a reversal. You actually knew this was a reversal when price broke this level right here. But like I said, there's a strategy behind trading continuation. I will do a video for it. So I probably would have taken this trade, but if you're just following the three basic rules of trading right off the support and resistance levels, this wouldn't have been a trade you could have taken. Alrighty. But so we actually get our first trade right here. Right here. Right. So this is how powerful these levels are. Rule number one, be patient. Make sure it comes to the level. Came to the level, right? Came to the level. Rule number two, make sure your oscillators or your indicators, whatever you're using, confirm what price is doing. Price is getting weak right here. Doji candle, price turn roll right over for you. Trading to the downside. Now, what makes this a high probability trade? Because your moving average is telling you the same exact thing. All of your confluences are lining up and you're trading in the overall direction of the major trend. That's rule number three, right? So where would you like to take this trade? Again, major support and resistance levels. It goes, usually falls from level to level. So you'll try and get all of that move for 271 pips, right? In addition to that, you could have added, you could have took this trade. You could have got about 200, let's just say 250 pips out of this trade. But look, you could have added a position right here. Took another trade, 250 pips, because it did the same thing, bounced right off the level, right? And then you could have taken other trades like right here, right here, right here, right here, right here. But that's another strategy. That's trading the continuation strategy. So with this one move, this is why it's good to be patient coming off these levels of support and resistance. Because with this one move, let's say 250 pips, 250 more pips, that's 500. Let's say another 200 pips, 700 pips, another 100, and let's say another 200 pips, 900 pips, 1,000 pips, 1,100 pips, 1,200 pips off this one move. That's a continuation strategy that I'm gonna show you guys in another video, but that's why trading off major support and resistance levels are so profitable, okay? So let's look for another trade. And this is a 4-week time frame. So you actually made 1,100 pips in, let's say, 3.5 weeks. You did 1,100 pips, less than a month. So here's another trade setup you could have taken. It broke this level, it came back, it almost went up to resistance level, but it didn't quite. But your oscillators and everything turned over and put you into the trade. So once it broke this level, once you have to pull back right here, back into your resistance, that's another trade you could have taken. 300, just say roughly 300 pips, okay? Again, price broke the level, came back, retested the level, gave you another trade, 185 pips, right? And you're getting these trades. This trade right here, guys, and this trade happened in the same week. Happened in the same week. So that is the advantage of trading off major support and resistance levels, because once you plot these levels on the chart, price not only respect these levels, they really react to these levels, but you can generally trade them down from level to level, okay? Let's say if the trend reversed right here, started going to the upside, The reason I'm saying it reversed right here, because this gave you confirmation when you got to this point right here that the trend already had reversed. If you needed more confirmation if the trend reversed or not, say right here. If you needed more confirmation of whether or not the trend reversed, you could just go to a daily time frame. And as you can see on the daily time frame, one time frame higher, you can confirm that the trend has actually reversed. Actually, a lot sooner, a few days later, you could have the trend reversed if you're a countertrend trader, because this is still an overall downtrend of the market. But you can tell right here, confirming from the daily time frame, that the trend had reversed, right? So it could have gave you, more confidence to take trades in the other direction, right? And like I said, price is attempting to make it back to this level right here. I think this week, price will make it up to this level, even though it looks like price is falling right here. But if you look on the charts, you can see the highs are getting higher, right? Or you want to look for hidden divergence in price. You can see right here, yeah, price is creating lower lows on the price, but momentum is getting higher. This is what you call hidden bullish divergence. Lower lows, but momentum is going up, usually for a breakout to the upside. Okay? Alrighty, guys. So that's how you trade off the support and resistance levels. The higher the time frames that you trade off, gives you higher probability trades. But no matter what time frame that you trade, once you plot in your major levels, price tends to break these levels or reverses off these levels, it's usually going to the next level of support and resistance. All right, guys, if you've learned anything from this video, please like the video, subscribe to the page, and share the video. Forex King.